Hey y'all, it's your boy Big Mike. You know that dude you be sitting on the streets and be like, hey, ain't that dude that be doing them YouTube videos? Yeah, that's me. And today is Christmas. Merry Christmas, everybody. And Happy New Year's, because even though today I'm recording on Christmas Day, this isn't going to get uploaded until next Thursday, so just look for it. I just had to get one more Christmas video chat in, but yeah, I'm about to get it in right quick. This is technically a beef rib versus baby back rib, and I just have a few sides here, some spaghetti and some dressing, of course. I can't have no holiday go past without my mother's dressing. Even though she's gone on to a better place, I just want to say happy birthday to my grandmother. She died in 2015, and she would have been 103 today if she'd still been living, but she died at 96 years old. So happy birthday, Grandma, and happy birthday, Jesus Christ. Start with the beef rib first. Save the best for last, because I already know that I love my baby back ribs the best. I'm just doing a comparison because it's been a while since I've done or had any beef ribs. Y'all can do that beef rib over there in Texas, but here in Tennessee, we dine on the swine all the time. I'm not really mad at the beef rib, but it ain't hitting like that baby back rib, you know what I'm saying? Hashtag baby back ribs if y'all love pork. Pretty good. I had originally bought a sushi platter for today, but that was like 3 or 4 days ago, and I love sushi, so that platter hurry up and got gone real quick. That dressing is sure enough good to me, y'all. We got ham and turkey also for Christmas, but I just didn't put none of that on my plate. When I get seconds and thirds, I go back and get me a slice of ham or turkey. Now, not that it's BS, but now that I'm done with the BS, aka beef ribs, we're gonna go ahead and get off into the star of the show over here. Excuse me. I've been waiting all day for that. Good Lord. I just did a video about what the Bible says were unclean meats to eat. And swine was on that Old Testament list. But I'm thanking God that he died on the cross. And it's okay now for me to eat swine. What y'all be saying here in the South? Now that's eating. Good Lord. I just think the baby back ribs are more moist and easier to eat off the bone. That was just awesome right there, that bite. Just look at that. Just fall off the bone tender. Let me have a brief interlude. I got a letter, or I got a card, a Christmas card, from my mother's friend. Hey, Miss Maddie, how you doing? I hope you enjoyed the eats that my mom took you. But she sent me this card. It says, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year's. Thanks for sharing the wonderful eats with us. And it was her husband and herself who I sent the little chewables to. You have great taste. Hope the new year will be filled with peace and happiness for you. And then the card itself says, wishing you all the warmth of Christmas filled with happiness and joy. Love, Miss Maddie and Willie. And she sent me some greenery. Yes, sir. Love those kinds of friends. Now, let me finish off these ribs here. To hell with a beef rib, okay? On everything I love. That baby back rib is for me. I hate that I could only get one slab too. It's like Kroger's prices on the... text me or get in my DM when I'm shooting a video. But yeah, the ribs at the Kroger's, it's like the smallest one I got was like $12 and like 50 some cents for just one slab, and then they went up in price like 19, and then there were some spare ribs that were like $24. And I'm like, for one slab? Are y'all kidding me? And then I had to go to a totally different store just to get the beef ribs. And I had to go to the farmer's market to get that. And that's like an hour's drive away from my house. Like, well, damn. Those of you who know that I love my Modelo. And I might turn this bottle up twice, no more than that. I gotta get it in. Yes, sir. Excuse me. Not bad manners, just good beer. Let me set that cup down, or that bottle down right there. We got a birthday, Christmas card from my mother too. It says, with love for you. Excuse me. our shots. Look what we got here. This is for all the special things you are, for all the things you do. Enjoy this Christmas gift that comes with lots of love for you. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's. Love, my mommy. And she did it up. She put that big face on it. Yeah. Even though with my disability getting approved just in time for the Christmas holidays, I did put a few more hundred in her card than she did mine. But it's all good though, I ain't tripping. I'm blessed. Thank God I made it through another year. There ain't nothing better than a cold Modelo. That thing is absolutely delicious. The ribs, the baby back ribs, mind you. Followed by a Modelo, fresh out the refrigerator. Okay, y'all see where I'm going with this one, don't you? But let me talk about this little bottle that I got here. And this other bottle that I got here. Because y'all know from how I turned up last year, I was going to do more than just drink beer, right? Okay. I'm just making sure y'all were paying attention, okay? But I love, let me say that again real slow. I love me some tequila now. I only drink tequila twice a year. That's for my birthday and then to bring in the New Year's. So from Christmas until January 1st, we tequila over here. We party amigo, a Mexicante, okay? Yeah. So, excuse me. I got this pretty little bottle of Don Julio that's going to get opened up a little bit later. But this is my new bottle. My new bottle. I hope they keep this on the shelves. It's called Vodkila. It's a mixture of vodka and tequila, of course, which is the most beautiful thing there is. This bottle, this fifth, it costs $30. And then they don't even sell it in a half a gallon, which I'm highly pissed off about that. Like, as far as I have to go for alcohol, and to get two bottles when I'm sure they make it in a half a gallon. They just didn't sell it at the one that I went to. Mr. Wilkins Liquor Store in Collierville, Tennessee. But anywho, that is like the perfect blend. And it's like with this last this last little shot that I have in it, because it's like I bought this bottle like about 4 maybe 5 days ago, I forget when, but I've been getting it in, like having a good 2-3 shots a day at this bottle, and just barely made it last to Christmas over here. But man, come January 1st, I'm going right back to the liquor store, and they better have some more on the shelf, or it's gonna be a problem. You understand me? Ha! Oh, okay. Making sure y'all heard me. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I'm going to pour this little shot here in some apple cider vinegar. I mean, no, not vinegar. Apple cider. Just plain apple cider. I don't know how vinegar came out, but yeah, I got some cinnamon flavored eggnog that I'm about to put in this little cup over here. Well, it's already in the cup. I just gotta add the alcohol, but yeah. Yes, sir. This is how I end my New Year's. I mean, the end of the year. This is how I get down with the beverages and the fluids and whatnot. I'm just gonna take me a quick little sip of this eggnog. Apple cider. Right there. I should have did the eggnog like I did last year and put it in some ice trays so that I could just like have a real cold drink. But the refrigerator and the freezer is so full of stuff. Like I said, I still got ham and turkey and some other sides to get into. I just had the spaghetti and dressing just for this video, and it's already gone like over 28 minutes with just them two sides and the ribs. But yeah, the baby back ribs, they won. Like, they won, like, for real. Ain't no way in the world no cow, as good as the cow is. I mean, I love my hamburgers and steaks and stuff like that, but the ribs, they ain't messing with them baby backs. I promise you, they is doing Nathan to baby backs over here. Swine won that one. Oh shoot, man, this is gonna put me in a food coma when I get done with this drink here. So I done already chugged me a little beer right quick. Yes, sir, yes, sir. Apple cider and cinnamon flavored eggnog in the vodka blend. That was just delicious. That's gonna do it for this week, folks. I want to say Merry Christmas again and Happy New Year's. Y'all need to go ahead and drink responsibly. Have y'all a designated driver and whatnot. And get back to where you came from. And don't, you know, get in no accidents and accidentally take a life that you didn't even know existed. Because these people get out here and just forget that they're the only person on the road or whatever. But yeah, I would like for y'all to hit the thumbs up on this video and then share the video and comment if you like the baby back ribs versus the beef ribs. You say beef ribs, I'm gonna roll my eyes at you. But yeah, most importantly, could y'all please, please subscribe to my YouTube channel? I would greatly appreciate it. That's going to do it for this week and this year, folks. Next time you see me, I'll be doing, hopefully, a tube of terror. It's some hot peanuts that's like really high, like 13 million on the Scoville units, like hot, like hotter than the Choco Challenge that I made, that I did, which was only like 2.2 million or something like that. But that's going to do it for this week, folks. I'll holla.